Well, hey everyone, welcome to Eagle Brook Church Good Friday service. My name is Jeff Dodge. I am the campus pastor at our campus over in Anoka. It's so good to be with you. Thank you for tuning in wherever you are watching from. This is really a strange time in our world. I don't know anybody who is living the same way they lived just a few weeks ago. We are all adjusting to new rhythms and new routines. And if you're anything like me, you're getting used to trying to be productive while working from home. And like any office change, I'm still getting used to my new coworkers, who are my wife, Amanda, and my three kids, who are 4, 2, and 8 months old. And I know for a fact that HR would not approve of their conduct in the office. And maybe you were a stay-at-home parent before all of this began, and now you've been deputized. You are a stay-at-home teacher, and you get to experience all the joy that comes with that. Maybe you work in the medical field and your job is more intense than ever right now. And you guys are the real heroes. You are putting yourselves at risk. You are helping other people get better. You're helping our world return to normal. Meanwhile, most of us are just trying to not touch our face like 100 times a day. Maybe you are someone whose job was considered essential and you still go to work like normal, but when you go there, there's just less people and you're social distancing and it just feels different. You know, I begin to appreciate some of the differences in my own life. On most days, I appreciate that the pace of my life has slowed down by a little bit. I've also appreciated being able to cook and eat dinner with my family every night. And I have loved the moments throughout my workday where I get to connect with my kids. I also love wearing sweatpants. But also, our church has learned to appreciate some of those changes as well. One of those has been a whole shift to going online, at least temporarily. We are reaching people who would probably never set foot in one of our campuses. And if that's you and you're tuning in right now, we're so glad that you're with us tonight. We've also appreciated being able to do, well, this service. Normally, Eagle Brook does not do a Good Friday service because if we were meeting at our campuses, the marathon of Easter services would have already begun. And so because this is brand new for us, I want to let you know that our hope for our time together, that we would intentionally shift our focus away from the chaos that is happening in our world right now, and that we would focus on the price that Jesus paid for you and for me. To give you an idea of where this service is headed, we are gonna sing and worship God together. And wherever you're tuning in from, you can sing along with us. You can sit back and take it in, whatever you wanna do. And then we're gonna take some time to reflect on the sacrifice that Jesus made for us. And for those of you that have put your faith in Jesus, we are gonna close by sharing communion together. That's right, even though we're separated all over the world, we are still connected because at the end of the day, we are the church. We are followers of Jesus no matter where we are. And I know that a lot of you probably won't have the normal elements, the bread and the cup ready to go, but I wanna encourage you to grab anything. Grab a cracker and a LaCroix. Grab a crouton and a Gatorade. Whatever it is, the element is not important. What is important is what it symbolizes. The price that Jesus paid so that you and I could be free. That even in this time when our world is in turmoil and isolated, that we could remember that we are not alone. We're gonna get started with the service here in just a moment, but we're gonna give you some time to go gather those elements and meet back here. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and enjoy the rest of the service.
When the walls fell in the hall. Cried out for help. Did you hear the sound? Did your heart break? Does your heart break now?
My heart is breaking as I remember how it used to be. I walked among the crowds of worshipers, singing for joy and giving thanks amid the sound of a great celebration. Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? Now I am deeply discouraged, but I remember you. Each day the Lord pours his unfailing love upon me. And through each night I sing his songs, praying to God who gives me life. Oh God, my rock, I cry. Why have you forgotten me? Why must I wander around in grief, oppressed by my enemies? Their taunts break my bones, they scoff. Where is this God of yours? Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? I will put my hope in God. I will praise him again, my Savior.
Thank you.
sin washed away in your blood. Too much to make sense of it all. I know that your love breaks my fall. The scandal of grace, you died in my place. Yeah.
Into our time of communion together. And you can use anything, just something to eat and something to drink. It's a way to remember Jesus and all he went through for us. It comes from one of the final moments in Jesus's life. He's sharing a meal with his closest friends. And during the meal, he takes a loaf of bread and he breaks it. And he says, "This is my body given for you." And it's really a symbol of the incredible pain and sacrifice that Jesus went through for us. And then after the meal, he pours out a glass of wine into a cup and he says, "This is my blood shed for you, a new covenant," which again is a symbol of a new way, a new opportunity to have a relationship with God like never before. And he told us to share this meal in remembrance of him, to remember Jesus and all he went through. Now, I'm not great at remembering things. Being stuck in the house these past 3 weeks, my wife and I have been cleaning up our storeroom and going through old boxes. And we came across a box that said high school memories. So all sorts of late 90s stuff inside that box. But my wife and I also dated in high school. So also in the box was a ton of love letters that we used to put in each other's lockers, movie stubs, pictures from dances we went to, super cute stuff. But most of them I could just barely remember. But it was really fun to look back and remember the good stuff. And there were some things that I didn't mind forgetting. There were some things in the box that I don't want to remember, that I regret. And that's why remembering can be hard. There's a lot of stuff that all of us would prefer to forget. That's why we love to get to Easter. We like remembering good stuff, like Jesus victorious over death. But we don't love to remember the pain and the sacrifice, all that he went through. We don't love to see Jesus scared, alone, and hurt. I think that's why Jesus told us to share the meal in remembrance of him. To remember these last moments of life, because he knew we'd want to pass by it quickly. But if we are willing to remember, we have a chance to deepen our relationship with Jesus. Because as much as I love the stories of Jesus walking on water and healing tons of people and raising people from the dead, I've never done that. It's not a part of my life. But feeling alone, feeling isolated, feeling let down by friends, hurt, wondering if God's forgotten me, I can relate to that. That's where my story starts to connect with his. So tonight, let's not rush to Easter. It's on the horizon, but the hope of Easter only happens because of the heartache of Friday. There's no hope without the heartache. There's no victory without Jesus's vulnerability. Now, we avoid vulnerability at all costs. None of us woke up this morning thinking, "Oh man, I can't wait to be vulnerable this morning." And yet Jesus, in his final moments, shows us the power of being vulnerable. He opens himself up to all of the pain and the hurt so that we can experience victory. So in communion, we remember all that Jesus went through. We remember that Jesus was alone in a garden crushed with grief. We remember that Jesus was betrayed by one of his closest friends. we remember that Jesus was arrested and whipped and beaten. We remember that Jesus had a crown of thorns shut on his head while soldiers cursed him. We remember that Jesus carried his cross while crowds mocked him. We remember that Jesus was crucified. And with his final breath, he said, God, why have you forsaken me? We remember that Jesus went through all of that for us. Tonight, do you feel alone? Jesus did. Have you been let down by the people you love? Jesus did. Have you experienced abuse and pain? Jesus did. Have you been mocked for your faith in God? Jesus did. Do you feel like God's forgotten you? Jesus did. And from the vantage point of the cross, Jesus remembers us. He sees each one of us in our pain and our hurt, and he says, I'm doing this for you so you can have victory. Right now, for those of you alone in a hospital room, he sees you. For those of you overwhelmed at home, he sees you. For those of you trying to figure out how to make ends meet, he sees you. For those of you feeling guilty for yelling at your kids, he sees you. For those of you staring at the bottom of a bottle, he sees you. And what he says to you and me is, I'm doing this for you. As Carlos sings this next song, spend a moment holding on to that bread or cracker. Remember what Jesus went through for you. Remember the isolation, the pain, the vulnerability. And when you're ready, thank him. Thank him that he was willing to go through that for you. And then take your cup and spend some time thinking of the areas of victory you hope for in your life. Where do you need to experience something new? Is there something you regret? Something you need to confess? Bring it to Jesus. Because through your vulnerability, victory is possible. And as you drink, remember Jesus sees you. You're not alone. He knows what you're going through. He loves you. And he is making you new. Let's remember.
thinking about, can't stop thinking about, can't stop thinking about your goodness, goodness. I can't stop thinking about, I can't stop thinking about, I can't stop thinking about your goodness.
The thing you remember most is how much God loves you, that he would give his only son to die on a cross and bear the weight of our sin and shame. So let's continue, let's close out our time singing to him tonight.
We'll call on the hurting, making perfect
Let's pray together. God, thank you so much for meeting us here tonight, for meeting us across Twin Cities in Minnesota, the United States, the world. God, we know even though we're separated by space, we are united in spirit through your Son, Jesus Christ. And he draws us in and he draws us close, and we are still the church. God, and we claim the victory. And that song we just sang, God, that tomorrow is coming and Sunday is coming and there's a resurrection ahead of us. So God, as we just close out our time tonight, we just love you. We're thankful for your Son, Jesus Christ, who died on a cross for our sins. And along with that came a promise of hope and peace and eternity spent with you. So God, we give you all glory. Belongs to you. Through the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
What a great reminder for us tonight that in your life and in my life and in our world today, that the cross gets the final word. At our Good Friday service, we focused a lot on Jesus' sacrifice and his death. But on our Easter service that is coming up in just a couple of days, we focus on Jesus' victory over the grave, his resurrection, and how that gives you and I hope. You're not gonna wanna miss Easter service at Eagle Brook this year. We have four different service times, starting tomorrow on Saturday at 4 and 6 p.m. and then on Sunday at 9 and 11 o'clock. And then it'll be available on demand after that. But hey, until Easter gets here, thank you so much for tuning in tonight. Take care, everybody, and we'll see you later.